I've spoken here many times, and over the years...
On the national stage, Mississippi Governor Haley Barbour has had a lot to say as a potential contender for the 2012 Republican presidential nomination. But in his home state, Barbour's comments were brief when reporters asked about a move to create a special license plate honoring Confederate General Nathan Bedford Forrest, who was a KKK leader and slave trader. The state's NAACP had called on Barbour to denounce it.
I don't go around denouncing people.
Barbour added there was little chance the state legislature would approve it.
The Nathan Bedford Forrest tag is not going to happen. Isn't that what you asked me?
I mean, do you know?
Is that what you asked
me? Yeah, that's what I asked.
The answer is it's not going to happen.
The governor's answer fell far short of what Derek Johnson was looking for. He's the president of Mississippi's NAACP chapter.
You've heard the governor's response. What do you say to it?
Well, I think the governor cannot tap dance this issue. If Mississippi is going to grow out of its racial past, we have to address racial issues head on. Anytime an organization such as the Son of Confederate Veterans feel comfortable enough to pursue a state-issued license plate, it tells you something about the atmosphere and the political discourse in this state.
The Sons of Confederate Veterans is behind the effort to honor General Nathan Bedford Forrest. Besides being a KKK leader, there is also controversy about an 1864 raid at Fort Pillow, Tennessee, and whether Forrest condoned the killing of hundreds of black Union Army members. Greg Stewart of the group says Forrest is being unfairly maligned. He calls him a military genius and told station WLBT,
"If we can't hold him up to where he's supposed to be, then nobody else is going to do it."
But already, more than 2,000 people have signed up to a Facebook page stating, "We will not stand for the public glorification of one of the original leaders of the Ku Klux Klan."
We did reach out to Governor Barbour asking for an interview, but his office said his schedule was full Wednesday and he was unable to speak with us. Mary Snow, CNN, New York.